us to go really deep tonight. I want us to go deep. I mean, the Holy Spirit is the one that takes all of us in different places, of course, but before the service, the Lord said he was going to take us deep in a place of worship, deep in him as we're drawing near to him, in a place that we will be invisible, invincible, and untouchable. Whoo! Sounds like the kind of people that can do any mission that's impossible. Hallelujah. So I want to read, I want to go back to Hebrews chapter 10. Oh God. Whew. Did you feel that? Wow. Whoa, did you feel that? Right? See my leg? It's like, should I shake my leg or itch my head or wipe my nose? Oh my God! Woo! Worship service and the Lord is here. Go figure. Oh God, sorry. I mean, oh yes. Oh my gosh. Woo! Huh? Do you feel this? Oh my God, remache de bon schlag. Woo! Whoa! I love this because whatever the Lord is about to say to us, there's always an anointing to follow the word. So when there's an anointing that also prepares the word, and there's also an anointing during the word, that when Peter preached, as the word was preached to the 3,000, they went, oh, you talk about interrupting a meeting. Okay, I didn't read the thing. Okay. Verse 19, chapter 10 of Hebrews, verse 19 through 25. Therefore, brethren and sisteren, having boldness to enter the holiest by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way which he consecrated for us through the veil that is his flesh, and having a high priest over the house of God, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. And let us consider one another in order to stir up love and good works, nor forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as is the manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. And in looking at this whole passage in drawing nigh, there's at least seven different things, but I want to relate it to worship tonight. And There's four great blessings of this new worship, and there's four marks of a true worshiper I want to cover.
I have no idea what they are, but we're going to listen to them. Sorry. Woo-wee! All right. This is just awesome. I love the Lord so much. Just don't know.
You see here, having boldness to enter the holiest by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way. So the holiest that's opened by the blood of Jesus is the first blessing. I don't know if you understand what the holiest is, but I think as we grow from glory to glory, we learn to understand what the holiest is. Because the Lord here, we wouldn't read for us to draw near if there was not a drawing near that we should enter. And we need to know this holiest that we are entering in. And of course, the holiest, if I can put it in a simple term, would be the spiritual heaven that we are in now. Hallelujah. There's a heaven. There's a physical heaven, of course, that is outside of this realm, of this earth, as we know it, of course. But because God is omnipresent, and because Jesus is our forerunner, he's our leader, he's our forerunner. And because of what he has done, he has broke the veil that we can enter in the holiest. Now. So that, I mean, this is huge because you have to understand that only the high priest could go in once a year, all the way. I mean, if anybody would go in, they would like schlack. Not under the power of the glory, but like, phew, dead. What gives you the right to come in? And even the priest would have to go through a whole bunch of things to make sure. And can you just think to do that year after year after year after year? Can you just think of this incredible passage of another great blessing, yes, Lord, which is the new and the living way that he has made, the holiest. You know, we pray, let it be done on earth as it is in heaven. You know, when you worship, the great blessing of this new worship is in the old covenant, you couldn't go in. But now we can. We can. Jesus is the way, and the new and the living way that he made is, it's not just a new way, but it's a living way. Because what a greater blessing can we have than to have a high priest over the house of God? Do you know any greater blessing of worship? That's why the scripture tells us that even Father is seeking those who worship in spirit and in truth. He's looking. And I know at glory to glory, you see a whole bunch of people and he's like, whoa. They're not giving me lip singing. Singing from their heart. They worship me in spirit and in truth. This living way is by the way that we move and we walk. This living way is any time, any place that we are, by faith. We are in his presence. We are in our spiritual heaven. And everywhere we are, we bring it. God says, when you move, I move. You have never to be concerned about going to a place where God is not. Oh. If God is not there, you're bringing him with you. And to me, it really helps us as we walk and we pray for our loved ones. And sometimes we see them going the wrong way. Sometimes we wonder, Father, am I going the right way? I mean, we're pretty sad, you know, to get to be 85 years old. And
I've been going the wrong way. And now I'm so old, I can't even go another way. They took my driver's license. They took my teeth, my hair, my cane, my knees. They're all gone. I'm 85. I can't go anywhere. Wouldn't you be just like, bummer? Be like, wow, totally missed that one. Too bad I can't even start again now. I'm 85 years old. Right? But oh, when a believer worship the Lord in spirit and in truth, which means love the Lord, believe in the Lord, have the heart to follow the Lord, have the heart to surrender and do whatever the Lord wants them to do, then don't you see that because it's the new and living way, day by day, you can't never miss God. You can't never fail because you're already in the way. Because Jesus is the way. When you worship Him and you know that He's the new and living way, it's like Jesus didn't just make a way and He's the leader and the forerunner, but then He's living as a high priest to give us the strength to walk in the way that He has made a way for us to walk in. So that's why the scripture says that the steps of the righteous, of a good man, are ordered by the Lord. And then it says, and He delights in His way. Well, yeah, you delight. It really doesn't matter to you where you're going to end up, because you're already in Him. You're already in fullness. You're already in Him. So, you know, along the way, you just go here, you just go there, you might not even really know all the reasons why. But you're led by the Spirit. That's why, you know, as a child of God, that's why Paul says, in whatever state I am, I've learned to be content. Because he's the way. In jail, locked up. Paul. And then he was telling everybody, rejoice. Again, I say to you, rejoice. What? Are you tripping, Paul? You locked up. What do you mean? What are you talking about? What do you see? Where are you? What's going on in you? And you can see that Paul got a handle of this Hebrew thing. Let us draw near. Amen. He said, oh, let us enter the holiest with boldness. With boldness. Not depending of our inability and the thing that we didn't do and our failures and what if I fail and I've failed and what if I fail again and what if my children fail and maybe I failed my wife, maybe I failed my husband and maybe it's my fault that I'm single, maybe if I would have done it right and my children are this and because I'm the one, I failed. And Jesus says, draw near with boldness. Bring in your children with you. Bring in your grandchildren, your finances. Bring in your health. Bring everything that you are. And just come on in. Draw near with boldness. And then it says, "Whoo! You have to hear the great blessings of this new worship. This is a new worship. This is the new tabernacle. This is the new covenant. Whoo! Glory! Hallelujah! That cannot be bound. That cannot be locked up. Ha! Forever! Jesus! My God! Woo! Greatest worship team ever!
Whoa! Woo! Right. These lies, the church. The church has been so bound. Man. Woo! Oh, I'm getting excited. Oh, God. Woo! He says, listen, I'm going to reread this verse 19 because I don't seem to get out of it. But those four great blessings in it of worship. Therefore, brethren, having boldness to enter the holiest. And it says, by the blood of Jesus. Boldness by the blood. Last Wednesday, he showed us. And he said, plead the blood, plead the blood. He said, help the people of God at every service. Plead the blood of Jesus over you, your life, everything, that the enemy will just pass you back by, that you will just be invisible, invincible. The blood of the Lamb that cover every post of your doors, because the door, the great I Am, has made a way for us. That maybe in the natural we hear, but hey, make no mistake. What you see is not what you get. Hallelujah. In the kingdom, it's not seeing, it's believing. It's believing, it's seeing. Amen. Stephen, filled with the glory where they're stoning him. It's John, in love with Jesus. Put my head on your shoulder. Where was I? Oh God. It says, by a new and living way, it says, which he consecrated for us through the veil that is his flesh. Whoa! Sometimes, you know, you think of the veil, you know, piece of material. Oh, I don't know if you just got that. I'm going to repeat it again because it's so deep. This is deep. The great blessings of worship, says, by a new and living way which he consecrated for who? For us. It says, through the veil. And it says, that is his flesh. And the same way that we attain the great blessings, that we walk in the blessings of worship that we have, to enter into the holiest with boldness by the blood, the same way that we know of this new and living way is also when we just die to our flesh. Because the veil he broke, we can enter in. But our flesh will keep us outside. Because our flesh, like, really, God? Right? Really, God? Can I just leave my flesh outside? And he says, yes, you can. He says, just if a grain falls into the ground, and die. Paul says, it's no longer I who live. And the greatest battle that you go, think about it, to figure out, am I going the right way? Am I doing the right thing? Am I worshiping? Have you ever noticed how much battle comes upon the children of God just when they're trying to worship, just to sing? Be quiet, you don't know how to sing. Don't lift your right hand, lift your left hand. Don't you put your foot down. Don't you put it up? Don't you cry? Don't you laugh? Don't you open your eyes? Only close one. the flesh that's being battled. Not just in worship, but in everything. When you pray for people, well, you didn't say that right, and you didn't do that right, and see, they didn't get healed. And well, you had a word of knowledge, what, you don't know nothing? What you said was silly. Next time, keep your mouth shut. Don't you pray for people. But the ways of God is not that way that you keep your flesh under. It's the same thing when you're trying to walk into God's ways and wondering if you fail and what if I go the right way, what if I go the wrong way. No, 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 no. We've been crucified with him. We have this new and living way. And it's alive, and it's exciting, and everything will be for a lesson, and we don't have to let the enemy lie to us. And then, you know, where we sit on the prayer line, you know, where the people fall, and I remember one day somebody getting up and said, did people see me? I said, what do you mean? Nobody pays attention to you. Because the enemy comes in, even when you don't hear, right? Because the battle is the flesh. And as long as we know that we've been crucified with Christ, where we can just enter in this new and living way, of course the enemy is going to mess with you. Of course he's going to mess with you in the realm of the flesh. He cannot mess with you in the realm of the spirit. Of course he's going to mess with you in your soul, your will, your mind, your emotion. Of course he's going to mess with you in your soul. He cannot mess with you in your spirit. Of course he's going to mess with you. You know, well, when I go through battles, I always say, well, of course you're going to crash the computer. Of course you're going to do this. A pain in your body. Well, of course you're going to try to stop me there. But you can never get me off course. I will stay on course in spite of what you do while I'm on the course. And there's nothing that makes the enemy more mad than you worshiping in spirit and in truth. He used to lead worship. You understand that Satan used to lead worship? You understand how mad he is? He'll do everything that he can to stop you from worshiping in spirit and in truth. The reason here we don't have a praise worship team is because the Lord said, let the people be it. Because that was so important, and it is so important now to God, that when we get together, we worship him. We can't look at somebody else worshiping God. He's not the new and living way for us to just be a spectator. He wants us to participate, to enter in. The blood of Jesus helps us when there's guilt, when there's condemnation, when you're afraid to fail in the future, or you feel guilty because you failed in the past, or you wonder where you are now. I encourage you, when that happens, worship. Draw near to him with boldness. Tell your flesh to take a hike. Take your body under subjection. No, you are not in control. I submit myself under the Spirit of God. I present myself a living sacrifice unto God. No, I don't care if people see me worship. Let them see me. I love when you worship, Philip. Yeah. Because he's right there in the front row. And there's just Philip and the Lord. Right? And when I see many of you, that's all I see. I see you and the Lord. And it's like there's nobody else around. Isn't it beautiful? And then sometimes when you open your eyes and you go, oh, yeah, they're here.
It's like, oh, I forgot there were some other people there. But it doesn't really, in a way, that you are concerned whether people look at you or not look at you or whatever. But then it becomes so glorious when we worship together. When we have the spirit of laughter together. I remember going to a meeting and just rolling on the floor. Who's rolling on the floor? Now, in the natural, if I would ever try to roll on the floor. I've never been good in gymnastic. You know, the rope that they have, it better had a lot of nuts. I wasn't going to go into no rope with no nuts. That would drive me nuts. No, give me the nuts. So for me to roll on the floor, well, when I stopped rolling and laughing, because I was looking for a bathroom by that time, it was like 3 hours had passed. And I was way somewhere, and I said, Lord, how did I get here? And the Lord, I remember, he said, I took you all the way. It didn't matter to your flesh. It didn't matter to you. He said, I completely took control of your body. I said, well, can you do that when I'm sit down and just, you know, like. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, can you do that when I'm all made up and my hair is perfect and, you know, and my clothes are right and, you know, I'm sitting the right way and, you know, and, okay, move now, God. God is like, no, because then when you worship me, then it's only part of you that's worshiping me. You put your eyes upon me and you worship me. All the way. Then you let me do whatever. If I cause you to sing, you sing. If I cause you to lift your hand, lift your hand. If I cause you to sit down and just totally just say, do that. With spirit, worship me in spirit and in truth. Oh my! Paul in jail was more free than a lot of people out of jail. We can be locked up on the inside. 4 blessings of worship. And the 4, and what we see in the next passage is the 4 marks of a true worshiper. Do you see? In verse 22, it says, let us draw near with a true heart. So the first mark is the true heart. A worshiper has the true heart. They're not saying they're perfect. They got it all together. And they're holy, holy, holy on their own. They just come with a true heart. Because see, this worship, this new way, this worship, this blessing of the new worship in the new covenant is a heart thing. It's from the inside. It doesn't matter what we do on the outside. You could have a whole bunch of people and, you know, pick up a flyer that says, okay, everybody lift up your right hand. Everybody lift up your left hand. No, don't put the other one down. Keep both up. Everybody look up. You could have hundreds, thousands of people doing that on the outside. And have nobody worshiping with a true heart. And you could be sitting here tonight, and when you worship and when the Holy Ghost come on you, you don't do anything that's sin. But on the inside, you're drawing near with a true heart. The second mark that we see here is fullness of faith. You just believe totally that Jesus is there. You believe heaven on earth. You believe
who you are in Christ and who Christ is in you. You believe that by the blood you are free to enter in. You believe that you're accepted in the Beloved, that you are not a failure, that your Father is looking for you to worship that way. He loves it when his children come and say, Abba, Father, you have not given me a spirit of bondage again to fear, but a spirit that cries, my spirit, my whole inside, cries, Daddy, Abba, Father. Because it's in your presence that I have joy. It's in your presence that I have peace. It's when I'm the closest to you that all my troubles seem the further away. So Daddy, 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 draw me close. It's on the inside that Father looks for the marks of a true worshiper. What good would it be if people came to church and on the outside worship? You know, sometimes in church we learn to say the right hallelujah, hallelujah, at the right time and lift up the right hand or whatever, right? And then go home and not worship. Amen. But he's looking for the marks of a true worshiper with a true heart, fullness of faith because of the blessing of the new worship. You remember? Enter the holiest, boldness by the blood of Jesus. My God, isn't it glorious? And then the new and living way. And the high priest over the house of God. Whoa! And then the next mark of, God, I feel the thing on the thing for the thing on the thing. The third one is having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience. And then it says, and our bodies washed with pure water. A heart sprinkled from an evil conscience is because he got done talking about the old tabernacle and then the new tabernacle. And he's saying, listen, you don't have to sprinkle yourself with the blood of an animal on the outside. You sprinkle by faith your heart. The blood of the Lamb has been shed for us. Once and for all, we have boldness. My God, can you see this glorious gospel? Why would we try to add anything any other way when we have such a new and living way? No matter what we do, we know that it's not really about where we're going as much as we are going in Him and with Him. His word is the washing that it's talking about. Then it's okay. You sprinkled your evil conscience because of the blood. And it says our bodies washed with pure water. And I thought tonight, but the Lord changed what I thought before the service. but soon I wanna have the picture of the old tabernacle, the tabernacle, and show you kind of the thing on the thing for the thing. So we can get the thing. But the water is that with the blood once and for all was shed. But the water is the washing of the word day by day. And sometimes we hear a living word and we read the Bible, but how many know when the Holy Spirit drops a word? When you're going a certain way, the new and living way makes a way. When you going in any way, you stay on course because of that scripture. You have to know that you know that you know that you know that this is the gospel that he has made for you, because the enemy will try to get you off course. By everything that pertains to the flesh, everything that pertains to the soul. But it's in the spirit, by the spirit, that you can fight the war in your soul, that you can fight the war in your flesh. So he says the marks of a true worshiper that understand the blessings of true worship have entered the holiest. He's not talking about a worship service. He's talking about our service of worship at all times. He's talking about our worship in our heart when we're home and nobody sees. But God, we can't play games with God. Hallelujah. It's about the inside, not the outside. It's about the inward, not the outward. Everything that's on the outward and everything that pertains to the flesh and the doing and all that, that's just religion. That's ways, that's not the new and the living way. Amen. That's not the new and the living way. And the place of worship, a true worshiper knows that it's actually when you need God the most that you worship the most. It's not when you have a good day, because when you have a good day, the greatest worship that comes from our spirit of a true worshiper is when you're going through the worst time. There is nothing like a worship of a parent interceding for their child or grandchild that they love. There's nothing. Nobody can pray for your children like you can pray for them. Nobody can pray for your mate like you can pray for them. There's a worship, a trueness of your heart. I don't know if you ever met people that says, I pray for you.
Right.
No, we're talking about real stuff, amen? We're talking about real stuff. And sometimes in your flesh, in your natural, you may not feel like drawing near. Sometimes I know people, because things are not happening in their life, they're mad at God. Or sometimes because the enemy beats you up, you don't want to go near God because you don't know what God's going to tell you, based on the way that you've grown up, the abuse in your life, the misconception. You might have this picture of this father that as soon, you know, it's not like, come on in, and it's more like, schlack. Bad girl. No. It's the boldness by the blood of Jesus. It's our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience. Wow, wow, wow. Washing with the water of the word. It's with and by the Holy Spirit that brings the reality of our great high priest in our lives. Who can you feel this? And it's not an amount of time. You know, sometimes the enemy will come after you and battle you because you only had like 10 minutes to worship. We're talking about a heart thing. We're talking about a willing heart. We're talking about what you desire in your heart. And when you have that, you can worship him even in the midst of your job. You can worship God in the midst of cooking dinner. Some anointed food coming out. You can worship him changing the sheets. You worship him when you're driving and everybody around you is having an attitude. The other day I'm driving, there's somebody that gave me the finger. So I gave 5. Because I have the tendency when I'm drunk to drive slow. Because I don't mess up your driving to worship with a true heart and enter the holiest when you're driving. Right? can people get mad at you? No, we need to worship at all times. We need to worship at all times. He's looking for those who worship in spirit and in truth. Marks of a true worship. We learn to draw near just because we can. Why shouldn't we? I mean, Almighty God said, come on in. Oh, I'm going in. Tell me when to stop. I'm going in. The Lord is encouraging us tonight. In all of our lives, the word is draw near. Let us draw near. Let us do that since we have the blessing to do it. Can we do it? Can we do it? No, not when we come here, but we do it so much out there that when we come here, we all get cut off. The Lord showed me worship services that we won't need any music. We won't need any music. The worshipers will have a song over here and song over there, and we'll fall over here and we'll fall over there. And hallelujah. So lift up your hands. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Say, Lord, I draw near. I'm a true worshiper. I believe that I can enter the holiest. Let it be done on earth as it is in heaven. I believe. I go in with boldness by your blood. I believe you have made a way, a new and living way, that you are my high priest over the house of God. I thank you for such a blessing. And I go in, I draw near with a true heart, with full assurance of faith, with my heart sprinkled from an evil conscience, washed with the water. Jesus, I receive, I will worship. In every place, at all times. And truly, tonight, I take in my children, my loved ones. I plead the blood over our house. We are a house of worship. I will never fail because I'm in the right way in you. And you in me. Hallelujah! 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 Thank you so much for tuning in. I trust that this message has blessed you, encouraged you, strengthened you. The Word of God is alive, sharper than any two-edged sword. I believe not just in the Word of God, but the Spirit of God. So I release His touch, His anointing upon you right now. May you walk in total healing, salvation, deliverance. I would love to hear back from you. Send me your prayer request, your praise report. Know that you are not alone, that all things are possible with God. I pray His blessings upon you in abundance, in Jesus' name.